This tutorial is designed to inform parents of Pinellas County School students how to gain access to and navigate in the Focus Student Information System parent portal. The first step is to establish your parent account. If you registered your student using SRS, you already have a login account username and password. If not, report to any PCS school or the district student assignment office with photo ID, such as driver's license, state ID card, or passport, and sign up. Next, register an SSRPM and change your auto-generated password to something that is easy for you to remember. Third, report to your student's school with the same ID you used to establish your account and proof of relationship to your student, like the student's birth certificate with your name on it, or a utility bill in your name matching the student address, and have your account linked to your student. A special note, you may have to do some or all of the above steps if you previously registered but have never been linked to your student, or if you have not logged into your parent account in over a year. Once you've done these things, you're ready to log into Focus SIS. Focus SIS is a web-based product, which means you can access it from anywhere you have an internet connection. Let's see how to do that. First, open a supported internet browser. Chrome, Firefox, and Safari are supported by the district and the vendor. Second, type the Focus URL in the browser web address box. https://focus.pcsb.org or focus.pcsb.org for short. Finally, log in using your PCS parent username and password. Let's see what that looks like. This is the Focus login screen. You'll notice that I'm using a different URL for training purposes to protect the privacy of our students and users. I'm going to log in using my PCS parent account username and password. When your login is successful, you'll automatically land on the Focus portal page. The portal page has three distinct areas. The top ribbon contains the Pinellas County Schools logo, your name, the name of the school your selected student attends, a drop-down menu of all school years, the name of your student or a drop-down list of all students associated with your account, and a drop-down list of the valid marking periods of the current school year, defaulted to the active marking period. Located below the ribbon are the menus. The menus contain links to school information, your student information, your information, and assignments and grades. The rest of the portal page consists of what are called portal blocks. The first and largest block, featured programs, displays your student's active schedule and current gradebook average, as well as links to other programs that provide more detailed information about your student. To the right of featured programs is the alerts block. You may see links to details about an event involving your student here. Below featured programs is the messages block, where you'll see messages that the school or district wishes to share with all parents. You may also see communication options with a link to the most recently published report card. The remaining blocks are for upcoming events, parent programs, and learning resources. Let's take a look at how each of the areas of the portal page are used. The primary function of the ribbon is to select the student you want to view if you have multiple students in PCS schools. You can also change your marking period view in the ribbon to view grades from a prior marking period. And you can also change the school year. The Pinellas logo is also used as a home button. From any page in Focus, you can return to the portal page by clicking the icon. Now let's take a look at how to navigate in the portal blocks. We'll come back to the menus at the end, because most of what you find in the menus can be accessed through the portal blocks. Since we just finished a marking period, I'm going to switch back to the previous marking period and look at the Featured Programs block. Here, as before, we see the student's schedule, but over in the Grades column, now instead of having the gradebook percentage, we have a letter grade. This represents the final letter grade of the gradebook average at the end of the marking period. If I click on the letter grade, we'll see the assignments which make up that final grade. They'll always be listed the same way. You have the assignment name, the points that it was worth and the points earned, the letter grade, you have the date it was assigned, the date it was due, you have the date it was last modified in the gradebook by the teacher. This same view is available in each marking period as the teacher enters grades into the gradebook. You just select the new marking period and then click on the gradebook grade. When you're done viewing grades for one class, the quickest way to get back to the portal page to view grades for another class is to click the Pinellas icon. Another way to view the gradebook assignments is to use the menu item, Assignments and Grades. Simply select the class that you want to view, and it takes you to the gradebook grade page. From here, you can use the menu again to switch to another class. Another thing you can do from the Featured Programs block is direct message the teacher. Simply click on the Send Message link, and it will open a small window. Type your message and hit Enter. The teacher will receive an alert and will be able to respond to you directly through Focus. This feature can also be used on the Pinellas County Schools app, which can be downloaded from the App Store or Google Play. This function allows you to directly message the teachers on your student's active schedule. The student can also use this feature to message the teacher. Students are not able to message other teachers or students at their school. Students and parents are only allowed to message back and forth between the teachers on the student's active schedule. Other links in the Featured Programs block allow you to view student absences, student course history, and other informational areas about the student. All of these are repeated up in the menus. The Alerts block to the right of Featured Programs displays alerts about upcoming events, in this case, assignments that are due in the coming week. Below Featured Programs, in the Messages block, you see an alert reminding you of the end of the marking period. Below the message, you see communication options with a link to the most recently published report card. Simply click the link. Focus will produce a PDF copy of the exact same report card that would have been printed and sent home. Some schools, in a conservation effort, publish report cards exclusively and only print them on parent request. To return to Focus after viewing the report card, you'll need to use your back arrow. This is one of the few times you'll ever use it in Focus. The upcoming events block in Focus displays any events for the current week that are on the school calendar. When you click View Calendar, you'll also notice that upcoming assignments that have been entered in the teacher's gradebook also show up on the calendar. This is a good way for you to see what your student has coming in the next few weeks. Assignments will only appear on the calendar if the teacher has entered them in the gradebook. In the Parent Programs portal block, there's a link to the Student Reservation System, or SRS. Click this link if you have a student that you need to register for school for the first time, or if one of your current students wants to enter a district application program, or if your resident address has changed. The Learning Resources block is currently empty, but there may be times that the district inserts links to helpful websites or programs here. Let's finish up our lesson by looking at a few key menu items. First, let's go to the My Child menu. As I said before, most of the menu items can be found here in View All Programs, but sometimes it's more convenient to use the menus. If you want to see information about your child, click on Child Info. By default, you'll go to the General Information about your student. Along the top of the screen, you'll see your student's name, their focus student ID number, and their grade. To the right of that, you'll see several sub-menus. Many of these items can also be found in the My Child menu. You can look at your student's enrollment, their current schedule, their requests for schedules next year, their grades, their absences, discipline referrals, and test history. Along the left side, you'll see different subcategories of student information. By default, parents land on the general information page, which contains just basic demographic information about the student. But there's also a subcategory called addresses and contacts. Here you can see your student's registered address and any contacts associated with the student. Plus, once you're joined with your student, you'll be able to see your name down here as a parent linked to the student. Other items in the submenus are application program enrollments, exceptional student education information, and one key submenu is transportation, where you can see your student's bus route information if they ride a bus. The last menu I want to review with you is My Information, specifically preferences. You have the ability to set up focus to your own preferences. You can even choose the highlight color of the menu at the top, and you can determine how you want to view the data. More importantly, though, you can set up focus to send you email notifications about your student. Click on the Notifications tab, select the frequency of the notifications that you would like, and then check the types of notifications that you would like to receive. Once you click Save, you'll see a notice at the top that says you need to verify this email address. Go to that email account, find the letter from Focus, and click the link in the letter to verify this account. Once you've verified your account, you'll begin receiving notifications of the type you selected at the frequency that you selected. This concludes our tutorial on how to navigate in Focus SIS. One important thing for you to remember, as a parent user, you don't have the ability to edit any student information, so you don't have to worry about clicking in the wrong place. Your access is view only. What I hope I've shown in this tutorial is that there are a number of different ways to get the same information. So I hope that you'll explore and find the way that works best for you. Our hope at Pinellas County Schools is that you can use Focus SIS to assist us in helping your child succeed. We're happy to partner with you in working towards 100% student success.